past, what, 3 years, 4 years? Was it four?
Four.
Four. The past 4 years, Tom Toce has been like one of our Santa Clauses, who has come in every year and done one show, and this year two shows, all of which have helped us raise money for the outreach program. He is truly a gentleman, extremely talented. I'm so grateful that he is part of the Urban Stages family. So without further ado, Tom Toce and Circles. Oh, and please turn up your cell phones. Thank you.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Circles. So this show came about. I produced a show at 54 Below last fall, and the one before called the Harvard Yale Cantata. And Frances Hill came to the Harvard Yale Cantata. Her husband's a Yalie, and was so wowed by the talent that she asked me to help bring some of that talent onto the stage and at Winter Rhythms. And we did that last night, a bunch of young Yale performers. And in the Harvard Yale Cantata, most of the performers are young performers looking to make their mark. Some of them are currently making their mark, but it's all about upswing as far as the young composer, the young performers go. However, my favorite round in the Harvard Yale Cantata was called Old Timers Day. And it was a round that I devised using two of my oldest friends, really, Peter Lerangis and Kim Oler. And I was wowed by their two songs. They're kind of in competition. It's a lighthearted competition. And I can't decide which of them I liked better. I liked them both. And the songs that they chose, and that you'll hear tonight, those two songs were kind of about the arc of life. And Kim had sung another song that I co-wrote with him a year earlier in the Harvard Yale Cantata, which was also kind of about the arc of life. So that gave rise to the idea of the first circle tonight, the circle of life. And then as we're putting the show together, I've got a lot of circles in my life. A songwriter circle comes next, and then we'll bring it full circle. So that's really the idea of the show, Circles. So let me please introduce Kim Oler and Peter Lerangis.
You don't look bad for 86, do
you? Speak for yourself.
Well, happy holidays, everyone. Thank you for coming. Make it sound like a lot of people because I can't see a thing.
Thank you. Here's a song that's just a favorite of the both of ours.
Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly.
So many men seem dead.
but I won't rest until I know I've had it all.
So don't ask where I'm going, just listen when I'm gone. Far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble.
Eagles belong where they can fly.
I've got to be where my spirit can run free.
I've got to be where my spirit can run free.
Opportunity for me, and the idea of circles, which Tom put somewhat in my lap from what we did together and from other things that I've done, led me to think about what I was already thinking about in my life, which is that I've done a lot of different things. I've created a lot of different circles, and the one that I probably know myself in the best is writing songs. So this is one that I wrote for a musical based on Two Family House. It's about a guy who wants to start a bar and sing to his customers. He wants to be the bartender and the songster. And this is a song that he sings to an imaginary person coming in the door at the beginning.
Well, hello. Where you been? Will you look what the wind blew in? You're the girl that I adore, though we've never met before. I've been waiting for you all my life. Don't know how to explain, but the feeling is right as rain. You're the girl I never knew, yet you're deja vu. I've been waiting for you all my life. Never knew what I was looking for. Turned up empty-handed every time. Blew out the candle and locked my door. That's when you rang my chime. I can tell by your smile that you might even stay a while. The best things take forever, this I know. Better late than never. Never go. I've been waiting, waiting for you all my life. Waiting for you all my life. Thank you very much. And now please join me in welcoming Isaac Alter to the piano, and we know that Peter's going to come back up too.
Tom Toce brought me out of a 30-year banishment from the musical theater with an email that basically said, do you know anyone over 50 who could sing this song? And I was about to write him and say no, and my wife, Tina, who's right here, said, tell him you'll do it! So I did, mostly because I know the composer, who's a brilliant musician, lyricist, playwright, screenwriter named Michael Mitnick, and he's in London right now, so he couldn't make it. Just imagine, although I haven't seen this show, the character is a guy who mysteriously carries around an old phonograph, right? An old recorder. That's a vinyl record player. And nobody knows why until this song is sung. The war was over. I was living with my folks. I yelled upstairs, hey Ma, I'm off to get some smokes. But my father called, why you need to smoke so late? I lied, I had a date. Free of my folks' enslavement, skipping along the pavement to see a brunette who I never met, but I never would forget how she looked in that dress. How she stuck out her hand and said, my name is Cecily Smith, and I hope you like music, 'cause I got two tickets for La Traviata. That's when I said, I hate opera. She smiled and said, well, lucky for you that you're with Cecily Smith. Who cares what you are listening to? It's who you're listening with. We take our seats, our hands are folded in our laps. If not a kiss, then I at least will get a nap. But I close my eyes as the orchestra begins. And I hear violins, and the hair on my neck is rising, a feeling new and surprising. But it wasn't the sound that made my heart pound. No, it was because I found that her hand is in mine. And that's where it'll stay until they play the final chord. Says, were you bored? And I said, I guess it wasn't quite so bad. It was the best time that I ever had. She smiled and said, well, lucky for you, I've got seats to Beethoven's Fifth. Who cares what you are listening to? It's who you're listening with. A year and then
did it for La Traviata. It's sad but true how much I miss you. I miss you, Cecily Smith. Life is not the things that we do, it's who we're doing them with.
I said, who said I was going to have to follow that? Well, I'm back in my circle, but this moment it's a different one. This is the circle of having found someone and thinking, wow, it's not just that she came into the bar, but maybe she's going to stick around. Well, one hopes so when one sees this person. This is a song I wrote for my wife when we had decided to get married, and I would perform it at our wedding reception. It's called Baby, You're Always Right, and I'm Never Wrong. And somehow we end up agreeing.
Thank you.
Now, Tina, you're coming up to play the piano? Is that right?
Isaac
Stiggs. Peter comes.
We just worked it out today.
Say about memory, right?
say that.
Yeah, that's the theme. Memory and the loss thereof. And as my prop to prove it, I'm using words. The composer of this next song is in the audience, and I am really grateful that these lights obliterate everybody. This is the first time that this song has been sung by anyone in public other than the brilliant composer Sheridan Stevens. And so let's say now, one thing I have to say about Kim's song is imagine being married to someone like that and have that song sung to you at your wedding. I mean, is that amazing? I mean, someone in here actually, had that experience. I'm gonna go back pre-marriage because Sheridan seems to have written a song that verbatim details conversations that I had before I met my perfect woman, also at a bar, who is here right now, Tina deVaron. But before her, there was some prep. This is what it sounded like. You're always setting ultimatums. Make one more and I'll go walking out that door. You say I never really listen. That's a statement I am choosing to ignore. You try and say that I deny the way you feel, but you and I both know that that's not really true. You claim I never think of others. I guess that this whole thing is bad for me. Bad for me. Bad for me. You claim I make myself the victim. And I'm hurt that's even something you would say. You say I'm too passive aggressive. Well, I'm sorry if you really feel that way. You say I need your validation far too much. First off, I don't. But do you really think I do? I'm not self-centered or neurotic. It sounds like this whole thing is bad for me. Bad for me. Bad for me. You say I'm heartless and robotic. And with that, I am unable to comply. You say I'm acting like a child. And okay, I know you are, but what am I? So now you're saying that you have to walk away. And so I'm leaving you this final guarantee. Since you complain I'm too sarcastic, you're leaving. And I'm sure that's good for you. Good for you. Good for you. And who's next? Kim. Singing a song that he wrote just recently.
But as I thought about this this whole notion of circles and how we get roundabout places where we end up, I wanted to do a song by a songwriter that is so beyond amazing, and one who really inspired me, and who, we need to say nothing about him, but about me simply, that I love this, and I think the reason why I chose it is because this is what happens after you find a really good mate. You want to dance. Heaven. I'm in heaven. And my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I see when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Heaven, I'm in heaven, and the cares that hung around me through the week seem to vanish like a gambler's lucky streak when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I like to climb a mountain or to reach the highest peak, but I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I'd like to go out fishing in a river or a creek, but I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Dance with me, I want my arms about you, the charms about you will carry me through to heaven. I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I see when we're out together dancing, out together dancing, out together dancing cheek to cheek. Now we're bringing Tina up here to play the piano, along with Tina. Yep.
Century, but one of the best composers and lyricists of the entire 21st century, Tina deVaron. Yeah. If I knew how to bring you the morning so that nothing would scare you, it's all I would do. And if I knew how to send you a warning so that no one would hurt you, that's all I would do. And if I knew thank you.
that's all I would do. And if I knew how to help you laugh again, how to help you make a friend, that's all I would do. And if I knew how to take those tears away, how to make it all okay, how to help you face the day, if I knew how to make your dreams come true, that's all I would do. Baby, if I knew, that's all I would do. Baby, if I
say it again. I don't want to go after that. But I will, and I will somewhat hopefully that what I'm going to sing now will reach one particular person in this room. First of all, the lyric is by Tom, who brought us all together, Tom Toce. And I can tell you that when you write your own lyrics and when you write your own music, it's really hard. But when somebody hands you a really beautiful lyric, it's really nice, because that's one thing that you don't have to worry about. You just have to find a way to clothe it that's honestly worthy of it. Well, this is a song that, it's about a different part of the circle. It's about having gotten to the part of the circle where you're gonna have to start some new ones. And I send it out to this person who's been like a second father to me my whole life. He inspires me as a person in every way, but one of the most important ways is as a husband and a father. And I send this out to Bruce with great love and with great appreciation for what he shows me and what I hope I can show Cece, my wife. The world has its attractions, some are worthy of a glimpse, and I'm grateful for the traveling I've done. And I'm grateful for the people, nice to meet you, that I've met, and for all of the beginnings that I've begun. But the older, more mature I grow, the less I find that it matters one iota in the end. And what matters, really matters, is the life I spend with you, my partner, my lover, my friend. After all the nameless faces, after all the fancy places, I recall that the face I love the best and the touch I crave the most belong to you. Astounding. However,
After all the fears you've shattered large and small, there is one surviving fear. It's the fear that no one's there, and no one's gonna answer when I call. Anytime I may call, and you answer, after all.
Thank you. Well, thank you, Isaac.
By this following song, and that's okay, but I'm up here and you're down there, so it's tough. We love Bob Dylan, right? We love Bob Dylan, yes? The Nobel Committee loves Bob Dylan. But there was a little fracas about all of that, which part of which I'm explaining here in this song, which is a Bob Dylan song that has been reworked. You are all welcome to come in on the last verse because that verse is the original, but you're not welcome to come in on the first verse because I would like to sing that alone.
The line is
Forgive me, Bob Dylan. So now we make the transition to the second part of the show. And I'll get the mic over to Tom for the songwriter circle.
Hey. Thanks, Peter. Thank you.
You need this?
No.
So we tried to, you know, make these transitions as smooth as we could, but we have two kind of disparate circles here. Anyway, let's see what we can do. There's a theory afoot that says that the whole reason that I devise everything, that I devise the show, everything now has just been pretense. This is really just a ploy to get me to be able to share the stage finally with the brilliant Joe Kroger. So, Joe, when you're ready, I'd like to turn the first song in the songwriter circle over to you.
Thank you so much. Hi, I'm Joe. That's me. I did this whole part as elegantly as possible. It didn't go well, so. Had I known these guys before we did this show, I would have been devising plans to get us all together too, so now I know. And I'm thrilled to share this circle part with Tom and Martina. The whole theme of tonight, this afternoon, not tonight, is circles. And this is about, well, it's a fairy tale about life. Just needed one thing to make you feel me in August. Thought I'd be strong. Thought I'd be strong. Well, you got wrong. Turns out that I'm just a coward.
Thank you. interested, supper jealousy. Her a walk upon the heath was just a walk. Let William write the poetry. When Coleridge comes for supper, their intoxicated talk could just be talk. But William and Dorothy were family, and it seems to me she must have known that William was the genie. And if you're betting on a genius in 1823, if you're smart, don't pick the girl. Yeah, if you're smart, don't pick the girl. William Wordsworth's sister made the dinner and did the dishes. She probably had some help, but not from William. William Wordsworth's sister kept the larder and the inkwells filled and researched all the cures for constipation.
The idea of circles is that, you know, the guys in the first set set up circles so well and covered so much that I feel as if I can stay in theme and go nearly anywhere on the circle. So this song is maybe at 4 o'clock on the circle, or 7 o'clock if it's a second marriage. And if you're wondering, Joe or Tina, you know, or any women out there, what a guy might go through, hypothetically, in deciding whether to commit to somebody, it might go something like this.
Tried anything and failed at it. That might just be me. But speaking of circles and doing the same thing over and over and over again, this is a song about when you try and you fail, and then you go to try again, and you're just a little more wary, and you're like, I'll sort of try again, a little bit. But what this song is about saying, no, none of that. I'm giving it my all, every time. This is a song for Emma, wherever she may be, wherever she may be. This is a song for Emma, wherever she may be, wherever she may be. And I'm not backing out. No, I'm not giving up so easily this time. This is a song for the lonely, wherever you may be, wherever you may be. This is a song for the lonely, wherever you may be, wherever you may be. And I have had enough, but I'm not selling out so easily this time.
Back to the piano, the multi-talented instrumentalist Tina deVaron.
How many of you in the audience are New Yorkers? Show of hands. All right.
I want to know, how do you feel about that building? What is it, Park and 56?
Or
32
Park.
Yeah, 32 Park. Giant excrescence, right? It's a very tall building. What is it, 100 floors? Cathedrals to the dollar, lining Broadway.
home. I thought one day we'd trade it for a driveway, but it's still home. Yeah, it's still home. Now we watch the skyline change together and shake our heads and laugh at this forever. But I will never give you up to this wounded sky, even though they try to change the skyline. No, I will never give you up, you will still be mine. No matter what they do, no matter what they do to our old skyline. Let them go ahead and change the skyline. I will never give you up, I will never give you up, I will never give you up. Let them go ahead and change the skyline. It doesn't matter what we say, they're gonna change it anyway.
To a different place on the circle, the place on the circle that Peter explored before in Sheridan's song. This one's called More and More. It's about a relationship that didn't quite work out. I always thought that you were something special. If you left, you'd never be replaced. Thought for sure that I'd be disappointed in any other lady I am with. Now that I've been forced to do without you, it's looking more and more like I was wrong. You should see the women I've been seeing. I barely have time to write this song. More and more these days I find you're no longer on my mind. I've had others to caress. More and more I miss you less. Used to be I had to just accept it, the fact that you would always play around. Told my lonesome self that it was worth it, because you were the best I'd ever found. Guess that's why I nearly cried my eyes out that fateful day you up and said goodbye. Lately though I don't do so much crying, I thought you ought to know the reason why. More and more these days I find you're no longer on my mind. I've had others to caress. More and more I miss you less. Babe, I did my level best to please you. Threw a pile of money down the drain. Saw too many movies at the beach, you. And ate an awful lot of quiche Lorraine. Come to learn there's lots of ladies out there hoping for a simple, honest guy. I don't say I'll find another like you. I'm saying I don't even wanna try. More and more and more I find I don't even like your kind. Pretty darling, can't you guess? More and more I miss you. More and more I miss you. All you did was put me in distress. Please don't send your new address. More and more I miss you less. More and more I miss you less. More and more. Joe to round out the last round of the circle.
Yeah, this is my last song. Thank you so much, Tom, for bringing us all together and for having me here. I thought for the last one I would hit every possible circle I could think of, you know, life and death, relationships, gardening, religion. I know you're probably sitting there and thinking, how can I independently throw money at these individual musicians? And I know that both Tom and Tina do have albums for sale out there. Like a true pro, I switched guitar cases before I came today and left all my albums at home. But if you don't want to find me, I'm on all those streaming sites and whatnot. But this is a story about a woman named June.
Colorful tomatoes, like, I don't want.
of hands for Joe. And for Tom, and for Kim, and for Peter, and for Isaac. Oh my gosh, what a wonderful group. This is my last song for the circle. This has really been a lot of fun. Thank you. I was going to do something that I forgot. I didn't write songs until I had children. I was playing Cole Porter's piano 5 hours a night, 5 nights a week at the Waldorf Astoria Hotel. And, I had a union job. I had union health benefits. I had a husband. I figured, okay, let's make some babies. And then the most surprising thing happened, which was at 3 o'clock in the morning, when my son Nicholas was about 6 months old, I got a song. I mean, literally, what the heck just happened? And fast forward to many decades later, my son met a girl, he re-met this girl. He had actually been to preschool with her when he was 4. He'd take her to prom in high school as a friend. But after college, he ran into her on the 96th Street platform of the number 2 train when the train had broken down, and said, "Hey, what do you do? I'm living at my parents'. What do you do? I'm living at my parents'." And they fell madly in love. And shortly after they fell madly in love, I wrote this song. And there's a little PS to it, which is that they got married last June. So that's now I gotta really deliver, right? My son produced the album that it's on. It's on my latest album called Tuckerman's Ravine, which is on sale in the lobby. And I'd love for you to pick up a copy. And Nick played it on the ukulele on the record, and I had to figure out how to make a ukulele-like sound on the guitar. So here it goes. Except I didn't tune.
Sounds just like
that's a little ukulele life, right? If you're a man like your father, when you fall, you fall forever, and it won't be settling to settle down. I see it now. If you're a man like your father, you will hold on to her tight, and you know and you know what you have found. What you have found. It might sound like I'm bragging, but it's true. You'll know when she takes you to a place you knew you never knew. And you're a man like mine. It should come as no surprise. You're a man. Forever.
move out of the Songwriters Circle. This is my last contribution to the Songwriters Circle. And as far as where on the circle of life this one comes, I think it comes everywhere on the circle of life. When you're feeling all plowed under, nothing's gone your way. If you cared to sing, you'd sing the blues. I've a proposition you'd be foolish to refuse. Maybe you should walk in another man's shoes. When you lost your sense of wonder or your sense of play, maybe you've watched way too much Fox News. All your intuition says there's nothing left to lose. Maybe you should walk in another man's shoes. See someone's soul, and I don't mean their feet. Once you've touched someone's soul, rinse and then repeat. When your morning booms with thunder, skies are charcoal gray, pause a bit before you hit the blues. Carry someone else's load, it doesn't matter whose. Anyone is someone you can use. Maybe you should walk in another man's shoes. I don't mean their feet. Once you've touched someone's soul, rinse and then repeat. Life is full of pain and plunder, all the poets say, and it's over way before we choose. Get yourself acquainted with another person's views. At the very least, this will amuse. Props if they've got nose rings or tattoos. Maybe you should walk in another man's shoes. I said, maybe you should walk in another man's shoes. Wah, 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 wah. Maybe you should walk in another man's shoes. Thank you. And now I would like to invite Peter and Isaac and Kim back to the stage to complete the circle and come full circle. So this last song came about because, you know, I'm wearing a lot of different hats in this particular show. And one of them is I'm the producer of the show, which essentially means you send out a lot of emails trying to get people to come. It's the main function. And so one of the, about a month ago, I sent out a blast email to my Yaley mailing list, you know, because if you remember, last night's show and tonight's show had a Yaley component to it. Kim and I were, I guess, classmates at Yale, though we didn't know each other there. And I got a response when I to a show called Circle of Life from David Shire and Richard Maltby. Actually, it was Richard Maltby, the songwriter, who wrote to me and said, Circle of Life? Are you doing one of our songs in it? How can you do a show about the Circle of Life without a Maltby Shire song in it? And as I thought about it, that made perfect sense, and so I quickly devised this song. I remembered the song from the show Baby, which was one of my favorite shows. My wife at the time was pregnant with my first child, Hannah, and so Baby was a really important show to me. So this comes at the time of the Circle of Life when, again, a guy is deciding to commit, and he's pretty happy about it.
Same thing happened to me, man. Same show with CC and I.
Okay.
Amazingly.
So I'm going to channel my younger self and sing this. As I leave my single life behind, thoughts are kind of spinning in my mind. First I think about you, then I think about me loving you, then I think about you and me deciding we can be one. It's crazy, I know. I wrestled with my pillow all last night, and I look at you and I know I chose right.
Life's a very long road, and the crossroads come up right away, and it's sure hard to know which way to go when you've barely begun. And on the road you leave behind can shine so bright. I look at you and I know I chose right.
Now we may not have been much, you and I, and maybe our balloon will never fly. Maybe no one cares if we let things go by. Maybe it doesn't matter if we live or die. But if I'm making promises to you today, I wanna know I'll keep them all the way. And if I've not been good at meaning what I say, it's time now to try. So I think about you.
I think about you and I think about me. Loving you, and I think of my friends who say they're in love when they're just having fun. But I say no, no, no. If I am going to love, it's with all my mind.
I will be true.
I'll follow this through.
I know.